So good afternoon, students. So this is our first lab, MPMC, a microprocessor and microcontroller lab. So before that, in the Google, you can you are using a MASM, okay, Microsoft Assembler, okay. So for this, you can install. You need to install. Need to install one software that is DOSBox, okay. So in the Google. You can go to the Google, okay. You press MASM using DOSBox. MASM using DOSBox for Windows 10, okay. So why you are using this window DOSBox means we can't run MASM is nothing but 32-bit assembler. So we can't run this 32-bit assembler in a 64-bit process. So that's why we need to use this this DOSBox software to run this MASM program. Okay, so you can install this DOSBox, okay, in your system or a laptop, okay. And also you need to install this 8086 folder. The folder will be there, okay. So one more 8086 folder is there. That folder also you need to install, okay. So whatever the programs are there, you need to write in that. This 8086 folder, okay. So so this is a procedure. So procedure for the DOSBox. So you have to download and install DOSBox and download MASM 8086 assembler and extract this, okay. So whatever that extracted file is there, that you need to store in any of the a drive, either it is a D drive or a drive, C drive, not C drive, either D drive, E drive or F drive, any of the drive, you need to install this, you need to copy this drive, okay. So here so what I did, so now here DOSBox is already installed this DOSBox, okay. So I'm opening the DOSBox and whatever the 8086 folder is there, that is there in this G in E drive, okay. So here I will share this window. So this is the DOSBox, okay. So this is the DOSBox, okay. So now what I should do, so initially my 8086 folder is there in E drive, okay. So 8086 folder is there in E drive, okay. So initially this DOSBox is there in Z drive, okay. So what you should do, you need to mount that folder, okay. So you need to mount, okay. So you need to mount, okay. So I'm using mount, okay. So mount E:\ okay. You need to enter this command, okay. So you'll get this command, drive is mounted as a local drive, okay. So this mount E:\ means drive E is mounted as a local drive, okay. Now next what you should do, so you need to enter E colon, okay. So it will come into this one, okay. E colon means it will come from Z drive to E drive, okay. Next what you should do, CD:\ that folder is 8086, this is one directive. I need to go into this directory, okay. CD:\ 8086, okay. CD:\ 8086. So here, if you see in our syllabus, these are the experiments. You see, the first experiment is adding 16-bit number. Okay, so adding a 16-bit number, 16-bit number. So you need to do arithmetic instructions. Okay, so. Okay, so you see, so in order to go to that assembly means editor window, okay, you need to use an edit add1.as, add1.as. okay, so this main program will enter. Okay, it will go into the main program. Okay, so I will share you this one. 1 second. So see here, experiment one, so arithmetic, logical, and string instructions. Okay, so arithmetic, logical, and string instructions. Okay, of 16-bit and 32-bit number. Okay, so so this is write an assembly language program to perform 16-bit arithmetic operations. Okay, this is you are writing an assembly language program for 16-bit arithmetic operations. So apparatus required are CPU, keyboard, and Mason software. You need some Mason software. Also, you need a DOS box for executing these programs. Okay. So as I told you in class, you have four segments, no? Code segment, data segment, extra segment, and stack segment. So wherever you are writing the program, okay. So students, can you able to see this program? Can anyone give response so that I can move forward? Yes, students, yeah. See here, this program, this is a program, okay, for arithmetic instruction. Okay, so assume CS code. So that means this is assume is nothing but one of the assembler directive. I will tell you in the coming classes. CS is nothing but the, this is CS is nothing but code segment. Okay, so CS you are initializing as code. Okay. And code segment start. Start means for starting any program, you should use this start. Okay. So move AX comma 1111H, move BX comma 3333H. Okay. So next, what you are doing? Add AX comma BX. So you are adding the content of AX and content of BX. AX is a 16-bit register. Okay. 16-bit means it is in hexadecimal. Okay. So X is 1111H. Okay, if it is ended with B means binary, O means octal, and H means hexadecimal. And if it is not there, means internally it will be take. That means it will be decimal. So internally, what happens? Whatever the decimal value is there, that will be converted into hexadecimal. Okay, so it will add the content of AX and BX, and the result will be stored back to the AX. Okay, so this is the operation. And into 03H is nothing but a breakpoint, one of the interrupts. Total you have 256 interrupts in that. Into 03 is nothing but in order to avoid this program instruction pointed going to unwanted locations, you are using into 03H. Okay, so wherever you started the code, no? So next you have to end the code. Okay, so code ends. Okay, so the code segment, so whatever the code is there, code ends and end start. End start means you have to end the start. Okay, so this program I'm going to write in the MASM software. Okay, is it okay? Any doubts in this program, students? Your response?
Yes, sir.
Okay, yeah. See here, so if you take AX as 1111H, BX as 3333H, okay, so what is the result? The result is 1 plus 3 is how much? 4. So that means result is 4444H, okay. So you can take any value. Suppose I'm taking in the board, I will tell you. Suppose so if you see you are taking AX equal to some 896A, okay, 896A, and BX equal to some 4B H, okay. These are, remember, you need to remember that these are hexadecimal numbers, okay. So now I will tell you how to do this hexadecimal without converting into binary, okay. So 896A, okay, A64B, okay. So when you are adding, so A in hexadecimal, so if you see decimal and hexadecimal, okay, so 0 to 9, okay, so 0 to 9, 0 to, so on 9, okay, same, okay, so 0, 1 up to 9, same, okay. If it is in hexadecimal 10, this is A, okay, and 11, B, okay, 12, C, okay, 13, D, 14, E, okay, and next 15, this is F, okay, and next 16, it will start from 10, okay, so 16 is nothing but 10, okay, so you need to remember this, okay, so up to F you need to remember. Now if you see this addition, so what is A? A is 10 and B is 11, okay, so what is the result? 22, okay, but for hexadecimal radix is 16, you are getting the number more than 16, what you should do, you should subtract with 16. So what you are getting, so this is so 22 minus 16 is 8, okay, so 8 again you are getting carry, okay. So now 1 plus 6 plus 4, how much you are getting? 11, okay, so 11 in hexadecimal is how much? B, okay, so this is nothing but B, okay, and next 9 plus 6, so 9 plus 6 is 15, so 15 in hexadecimal is how much? F, okay, and next 8, 10, okay, A is how much? 10 in hexadecimal, so this is 18, you are getting more value than 16, if you have to subtract with 16, okay, so what you are getting, so 2, again you are getting the carry flag, so that means whatever the carry present in the flag register, that will be affected, okay. So like this you have to do, okay. Simply one more example, you take AX equal to some ABCD, okay, ABCDH. This is for more values more than 9, okay. So BX equal to what? BX equal to some BABAH, you are taking BABAH, okay. So what is D? D is how much? D is 13, okay, and A is 10. So if you add, you are getting 23 minus 16, so how much you are getting? 7, okay, so this 7 and the carry is 1, okay, and next 1 C D, so this is 1, C is 12 and B is 11, so how much you are getting? 4, 24, so 24 minus 16, how much you are getting? 8 you are getting, and next 1, okay, and next so 1, B is how much? 11, and next A is 10, okay, so this is 2, 22 we are getting, 22 minus 16, how much you are getting? Same thing, you are getting, so 22 minus 16, how much? 6, no? Okay, so 6, carry is 1, okay, and next So next 1 plus 10 plus 11. Okay. So 1 plus 10 plus 11. You see how much you are getting. This is 22. Okay. 22 minus 16. Again, you are getting the same value. That is 6. Carry flag equal to what? 1. Okay. This is the result you should get in AX. Okay. So now I will write the program. So, so what is my program? So assume CS code. Okay. So assume CS code. Okay. CS code and the code segment. Code segment. Okay, so I'll write this code, whatever the code is there, I'll write in the editor window. Okay, so don't leave the meeting. I will take the attendance at the last. So see here, so mount, mount E space, mount E space E colon backslash. Okay. So drive E is mounted as a local drive. Okay. And next, so next what you should do? So E colon enter cd e. Okay, cd 8086. Okay, so in 8086 my masm, there are three folders, masm, link, debug folders are there. Okay, now edit add 1.as. okay, so assume cs code ds data. Okay, so here example, I took 1, 2, 3, 4 and 6, 8, 7, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, this is one example. So, so 4 plus 8 is how much? C, and 3 plus 7 is 10. That is A, and 2 plus 6 is what 2 plus 6 is 8, and 1 plus 5 is 6. So my answer is 68 AC. That should come in the AX register. Okay. So 1 second. Is it visible? Okay. So this should come into the AX register. Okay. So this is a simple program. So exit. Now what you should do? You should write a command. Masm file name. What is my file name? add1.as. Okay. Semicolon. Okay. So for seeing the errors, you need to write this command. Okay. So you are getting 0 errors and 0 warning. Suppose in order to see the error, I will make some changes. So here I will remove the comma. Okay. So this comma, and I'm saving this file, and I'm exiting from the text editor. So again I'm doing edit add1.asm. Okay. So exit masm. Okay. So masm file name dot as. See here, I got a severe error. Okay. So that means it will show in the line. So in the fourth line, you have some symbol is not defined. Okay. So the symbol is not defined. Okay. So you need to see in the fourth line. Again, go to edit. Okay. Enter. So here comma is missing. So I can write the comma. Okay. Again, save the file, exit. Okay. Again, masm file name dot as. Okay. So if we got 0 errors and 0 warnings, now you can go to the link. Okay. So what the masm assembler will do? Assembler will convert whatever the assembly file is. Assembly. This is my assembly file. Okay. Assembly file into some object file. Okay. So that object file is given to the linker. Okay. So this link. Okay. So for linker, link file name. What is my file name? add1.ex. add1.ex. Okay. So here you need to write the semicolon. Okay. So suppose if you are not entering the semicolon, you need to enter 2 or 3 times. Okay. So add1.obj semicolon. Okay. Obj semicolon. So no, you should get no stack segment like this. Okay. Warning. No need to bother. You have to go for the next step. Debug file name. So what is my file name? add1.exe. add1.exe. Okay. So add1.exe. So this is a debug. So debug session is over. You will get some colon like this. Okay. So if you enter the question mark, this is help. All the commands, you can see all the commands. Okay. So A is for assemble, C is for compare, B is for debug, and E is for enter. If you want to enter some value into the memory location, you can use E space. So suppose if you want to enter into the data segment, DS colon, like this, you can enter. And H is X, and I is input. So mostly we are using G. G means if you want to run the whole program, you can enter G. Okay. G is nothing but go to that address. Okay. And if you want to see all the registers in initial state, you can use the R. R is for register. Okay. And if you want to see unassemble window, you can use U. Okay. And next, if you want to see the values step by step, that is trace. T is for trace. Okay. So these are all are the commands. So only we are going to use some trace and G and E and D. D is for display. Okay. So these commands we are going to use. Okay. So I'll use trace. Okay. So T is for trace. So initially I'm using R. R is for registers. Okay. So these all are the registers in initial state. That means previous state, some other registers are there, no? So how many general purpose registers we have? The AX, BX, CX, and DX, these are the general purpose registers, 16-bit registers. And pointer registers, you have stack pointer, base pointer, and the index register, source index and destination index, okay? And data segment, extra segment, these are the segment registers, data segment, extra segment, stack segment, and core segment, okay? An instruction pointer, as I told you, instruction pointer is always point to the address of the next instruction, okay? And these are the flag registers, okay? Flag register means NV means no overflow. Up is the direction flag. So up is nothing but the direction flag. Interrupt enable. Okay. So that means totally you have 6 conditional flags and 3 control flags. Okay. So parity lower, parity flag, not zero, zero flag, auxiliary flag. Okay. Not auxiliary. NA means there is no auxiliary flag is zero. Okay. So parity order and no carry like this. Okay. So you need to enter T. T is for trace. Okay. So first instruction, what is the first instruction? Move AX comma 1234H. Okay. So whatever the 16-bit value is there, 1234H, that will be moved into the AX register. Okay. Now again, press trace. Okay. So move BX comma 5678H. Okay. So BX, you got 5678H. Okay. Again, trace. Okay. So it is adding the content of AX, add AX comma BX. It will add the content of AX and content of BX, and the result will be stored back to the AX. Okay. So what is AX? 5678. So 1234 and 5678. As I told you, 68AC. 68AC is my result. Okay. 68AC is my result. Okay. So again, so into 03H, again trace means it will be program is completed. Suppose if you want to come out of the this output session, you can use Q. Q is nothing but quit. Okay. So quit. Suppose if you want to see the last output, okay. So debug G, if I press, you can see the last output. So G is nothing but C. So total program will be executed. Suppose if you want to see the step by step, you can use trace. Okay. So again, quit, enter. So if you enter the alt enter, full screen. Okay. Again, if you press the alt enter, you will get the half screen. Okay. So like this, you need to do the first program. Is it okay? Any doubts in this first program, students? Give response so that I can go for the next program. Is it okay, students? Give response.
Yes, sir, okay.
Okay. Oh yeah. So this is about the addition instruction. Suppose previously I see one example. No? Okay. So if you see in the program, same program, I'm using. So you need to remember one point over here. So move AX comma here A B. So these are the let us consider these are capital numbers A, B, C, D. This is not case sensitive. Okay. So here we are deleting B, A, B, A. Okay. So whenever you are, this is nothing but by seeing this one, this is a hexadecimal number, I can understand. But assembler will not understand that this is a hexadecimal number. So hexadecimal number, it will understand this is a character. Okay. So for understanding this number into this register, you need to add a zero. Okay. So when you add this zero, that whatever the assembler is there, that assembler will understand that this is a number. Okay. This is a hexadecimal number. Okay. So this program I'm going to execute. Okay. So file save, file exit. Okay. Again, MASM. Okay. If you press the append over arrow, that commands will come. Okay, that I'm already command. Some error is coming. Okay, symbol not defined. Okay, I will see that error in line 4. Line 4. Okay, so this one is nothing but D. Okay, so H is not there, so that's why H is not there in the hexadecimal. That's why it is saying that the symbol is not defined. Okay, so Alt+F(x). Okay. So massm. So we are getting zero errors and zero warnings. So next link. Okay. And next. So you should get the no stack segment. You have to remember link add one file name dot obj. Okay. So obj semicolon. So you should get this no stack segment. Again debug file name dot exe. Okay. Now trace, if you see trace step by step. One second. So Alt+F(x) massm link debug. Okay. If I press trace. Okay, anyway, this is the program for the addition instruction. Okay, now so if you see for the subtraction, okay, for subtraction you take this one I'm sharing. So if you see this program, so program assume CS code, the code segment start move AX comma 333H, move BX comma 1111H, sub AX comma BX. Okay, sub AX comma BX into 03H. Okay, so that means you are moving 3333H into AX. Okay, and next you are moving 1111H into BX. So subtracting the content of AX and content of BX, and the result will be stored back to the AX. Okay, and integer 03H is nothing but the breakpoint, and code ends and end start. Okay, so these are the results before execution. AX is 43H and BX is 141H. After execution, 3333 minus 1111. What you are getting? 2222H. Okay, so this is the result you are getting into AX. Okay, so this is the program. Okay, so this program I'm going to execute in MASP. Okay, so you see this one. So you can do the subtraction by using the 2's complement method. Okay, 2's complement or 1's complement method. Okay, as I you already seen in the digital electronics subject. Okay, so if you see this one, by using the MASM I am doing. So file exit, file exit. Okay, now edit sub 1 dot is. Okay, so don't give sub or add, those are predefined numbers. Okay, so so I'm writing the program. You can use this directive also, a small dot code. Okay, so assume CS code segment. Okay, code segment start move AX comma 3333H. Okay, move BX comma 1111H. Okay, next what you should do, sub AX comma BX. Okay, and next int 03H code ends and end start. Code ends and end start. Okay, so this program I written. So again, you need to save this program, exit. Okay, exit. Okay, now after saving, MASM sub1.asm. So you are getting two errors. Expected instructional directive symbol not defined. Okay, 3 and 9 you are getting error. So if you see, assume CS code segment start. Okay, code ends and start. Okay, so if I see start, in this start I need to write the semicolon. Okay, so start semicolon. Okay, so code ends and start. Okay, this is in the third line I have the error. Okay, so alt test alt fix again MASM sub1.asm, you are getting 0 errors and 0 warnings. Okay, and next link. Okay, link sub1.obj. okay, we'll get no stack segment. And next debug sub1.ex. okay, now what you should do, trace step by step. AX you got 3333H, again trace. BX you got all 4 ones. Okay, next trace sub AX comma BX. So AX minus BX is how much? 2222H. Okay, again trace. Okay, so our program is over. Come out of this execution unit. Okay, again you can go to the code. Okay, so like this you need to do the subtraction instruction. Okay, subtraction instruction. Okay, is it okay? Any doubts in this, students? Please give response. So till now we have seen addition and subtraction. Students, can you able to understand what I am telling? Give response. Okay, so here Next, I need to do the multiplication. Okay, so multiplication, if you see, okay, so multiplication, if you see, there are two multiplications are there, 8-bit multiplication and 16-bit multiplication. Okay, so if you use this instruction MULBL, okay, so MULBL, so normally what it will do, it will multiply. This is nothing but implicit instruction. As I told you, AL into BL, it will do AL into BL, and the result will be stored in where? AX. AL into BL, the result will be stored in AX. Okay, so let us take some example. AL equal to some 03H. Okay, so BL equal to, shall I take the big number? Okay, you can take the big number also, it's not an issue. Okay, so let us take 95H. Okay, and BL equal to some 12H. Okay, so what it will do? 95 into 12H. Okay, so here if you see, so when you are multiplying each number, you are getting the partial products. So when you add these partial products, you will get the sum. Okay, so 2 5s are how much? 10. Okay, 2 5s are 10. So in hexadecimal is how much? 8. Okay, so A you will get. And next 9 2s are how much? 18. Okay, so 18, if you convert into hexadecimal, what you are getting? 16 1s are and 2. So that means 1 2 you are getting. Okay, so this is 1 2. Okay, and next here you are getting 9 5. Okay, so this is A and this is 7 and this is A and this is 0. Okay, so this value will be stored in which register? AX register. Okay, so this is what is this one? 8-bit multiplication. 8-bit multiplication. Okay, now 16-bit multiplication, if you see, so 16-bit multiplication. So instruction is MUL BX. Okay, so this is we call as the implicit instruction. So that means it will by default it will multiply the with the accumulator. So AX into BX, the result will be stored back to the AX. Result will be stored back to the AX DX. Okay, AX DX. So that means whenever you are multiplying 216, this is 16 bit, okay, and this is 16. So that means whenever you are multiplying 216 bit number, the result can be a 16 bit or result can be a 32 bit. Okay, so when the result is 32 bit, okay, so lower 16 bit will be stored in AX and higher 16 bit will be stored in TX. Okay, you need to remember this. Okay, so in our example, in our this lab manual, so he took AX equal to what? Simply I will take my own number. Okay, so 1 2 3 4 H. Okay, and BX equal to some 1 2 1 2 H. Okay, so now what you are doing, you need to multiply AX into BX. Okay, so AX into BX, that is equal to what? 1 2 3 4 H into 1 2 1 2 H. Okay, so when you are doing 16 bit multiplication, the result is what? 32 bit. Okay, so if I am multiplying 2 4s are how much? 8. Okay, so elementary multiplication I am doing. 2 3s are 6, 2 2s are 4, 2 1s are 2. Okay, again you are getting 1 2 3 4 h. Again same 2 4 6 8 h. Again 1 2 3 4 h. Okay, so now you need to add this partial products. Okay, so whenever you need to add these partial products, so what you are getting, this is 8. Okay, and the next, this one is a. Okay, and next 4 3 8. Okay, so 4 3 8 is how much? 8 plus 3 is 11. 11 plus 4 is 15. 15 means what? F. Okay, so you are getting F. And next 2 plus 2 plus 6 4, so 10 14. So what is 14 in hexadecimal? E. Okay, and next 1 plus 4 is 5. 5 plus 3 is 8. You are getting 8. Again you are getting 4, and you are getting 1. Okay, so you can add 0 here. Okay, so that means you can divide these numbers into 2 4 4 bit numbers. Okay, so this value will be stored in lower 16 bit value will be stored in AX, and higher 16 bit value will be stored in which register? DX. Okay, so I will take this example AX equal to what? 1 2 3 4 h in my program. Okay, so BX equal to what? 1 2 1 2 h. Okay, so I should get this result. Okay, so when I'm verifying practically, I should get this result. Okay, so I'm showing this program. Is it okay? Any doubts in this, students? Whatever the theoretical calculations as I showed you, any doubts? Please give response. Okay, so see here, I'm verifying my program. So if you see, edit mul1.as, enter. Okay, so I'm writing the program. So assume, I'll write in capital letters, assume CS code. Okay, code segment start. Okay, move AX comma 1 2 3 4 h, move BX comma 1 2 1 2 h. Okay, you can initialize the DX. Why? Because the higher 16 bit value is there, that will be stored in DX. Now you can initialize the move DX comma 0 0 0 0 h. Okay, so and next mul BX. Okay, so by default what it will do, it will multiply AX with BX. Okay, so the result will be stored back to the you are getting 32 bit result. So lower 16 bit will be stored in AX, and higher 16 bit value will be stored in DX. Okay, so now if you see int 03h, okay, int 03h, and next codeends end start. Okay, so I written the program. So go to file, save the file, and go to file, exit. Okay, now masm file name mul1.as semicolon. Okay, I got 0 errors and 0 1x, and next link mul1.exe, I'm sorry, obj semicolon, enter link. Okay, so mul1.exe, enter. Okay, so sorry, here debug mul1.exe. Okay, so mul1.exe, enter. Okay, now I'm seeing trace, step by trace. So AX you will get 1234H, and next BX you are getting 1212H. Okay, so mul BX. So mul BX means it should execute this one, mul BX. Okay, see here. So so AX equal to what? EFA8, DX equal to 0148. Okay, so whatever I shown you, okay, that result you have to observe here. AX equal to what? So the lower 16 bit value is stored in the AX. AX equal to EFA8. Okay, whatever I showed in the theoretically lower 16 bit, I got EFA8, and whereas the higher 16 bit is there, that will be stored in DX. So that is a 0148. Okay, you got in the higher 16 bit is you got in the DX, and lower 16 bit you got in AX. Okay, is it okay? Any doubts in this? So I can exit. Okay, again I can go to the main program. Okay, so like this you need to do. Okay, so students, please give response so that I can move forward. Do you understood the multiplication operation? Anyone? So that I can move forward. Yeah. So see here. So while I did it theoretically. So you need to write the theoretical operation and practical operation. Okay. So when I see in the theoretical operation, so that means 1234H and 1212, I got EFA8. Okay. EFA8 in AX register. And 0148 in DX register. Okay, so like this you need to verify theoretically with the practical calculations. Okay, so next division operation. Okay, so div BX. Okay, so there are two types. Again, division operation. If I show you. Okay. Now next division operation. Division operation. Okay, so what the division operation will do? So here, if you see, there are two types of division. So one is 8-bit division. One is not 8-bit. This is a 16-bit division. Okay, so this is 16-bit division. 16-bit division. Okay. 16-bit division and 32-bit division. 16-bit division and 32-bit division. So first of all, if you see 16-bit division, you have div BL. Okay, div BL. So that means in the division you have dividend divisor. Okay, so when you dividend divisor, you will get quotient and remainder. Quotient and remainder. Okay, so by default, this div BL means BL is how many bit register? 8-bit register. Okay, so this is implicit instruction. So by default, it will divide AX by BL. AX by BL. Okay, so when you are dividing 16-bit, this is 16-bit. And this is 8-bit. Okay, so when you are dividing this 16-bit and 8-bit, what is the result? You are getting the quotient and remainder. Okay, so quotient will be stored in AL and the remainder will be stored in AH. You need to remember this. Quotient will be stored in AL and remainder will be stored in AX. Okay, so see here, div, one second, div bx, div bx, okay. So div bx means what? It will be dx ax by px, okay. So this is 16 bit and this is, sorry, this is 32 bit, okay. So this is dx, the 32 bit number is represented as 32 bit and this is 16, okay. So when you are doing this 32 bit division, you are getting quotient and remainder, okay. So quotient will be stored in ax and the remainder will be stored in dx, okay. So quotient will be stored in ax and remainder will be stored in dx, okay. So if you see some examples like 16 bit division, let us consider ax equal to some simple value like 2 to 2 to h, okay. So 2 to 2 to h and bl equal to some 1 1 h, okay. So what is the result? So when you are doing this one, so how many times, so quotient, so whatever the quotient you are getting, that will be stored in al and remainder will be stored in ah, okay. So we'll see this program. So mount e space e colon backslash, okay, e colon cd 8086, okay, edit mul1 dot es, enter, okay. Not mul1, div1, we are doing division. So exit edit div1 dot es. ASM means it's a assembly file, okay. So assume cs code code segment start move. So I will tell you the 16 bit addition, okay. Move ax comma 1 2 3 4 h, let us consider, okay, 1 2 3 4 h. Sorry, move bl comma some 2 2 h, or can say 1 1 h. Div bl, okay, int 03 h, students end start. Okay, so I written the program, I'm saving the program and exit. Next, masm mul1 dot asm semicolon, okay. And next, link div1 dot obj, okay. Second, masm l1 dot asm, you are getting 0 less than 0 means link div obj. So Second. Assume CS code, code segment, start 1, 2, 3, 4 H. Okay. So this is a 16 bit multiplication. Okay. Edit D1 dot is. D1.asm. We are getting one error. That is in 7th position. That is 03, symbol not defined. So int 03 H. Okay. So again, massive. Okay, if you are getting any errors, again it will not go into object file. That's why you are getting fatal error. Link div1 dot obj. Okay, no stack segment you are getting. Debug div1 dot exe, enter, then trace. Okay, so exe got 1, 2, 3, 4 H. PX has 0011. Okay, so div one second, or otherwise I will see for the 16 bit. So this is let us take 0002H. BX has 0001H. Okay, so let us take 4 2 DOBX. Okay. Awesome. Link debug trace. Okay, see here AX equal to 02. Okay, so AX equal to 02. I will change the number so that the remainder you should get in the DX. Okay, so you are getting remainder as 1 or 0. No, so I will changing that AX as 0005H. You can observe, okay, 16 bit division. So some div one. Next link, okay. Next debug, okay. So trace 05 bx ax you got 05 0005, and bx you got 0002. Okay. See here. So whatever the quotient is there, you got in 0002, and the remainder is there that you got in DX register. DX has 0001. Okay, so this is how you need to do this arithmetic instructions: addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. Okay, so if you see. Logical instructions. What are the logical instructions? AND, or not. Okay, first of all, I will explain you what are the instructions. So if you see this one, so see here, so till now we have seen the arithmetic instructions. So next you can see these are the arithmetic instructions, the division. Next, if you see, these are the logical instructions. Okay, so this is a program. Okay, so we are moving AX with 1111H, BX has a 3333H. Okay, and AX comma BX, and AX comma BX is what you know, the truth table of AND operation. Okay, if any of the input is zero, you are getting the output as zero. Okay, if two inputs are one, only you are getting the output as one. Okay, so convert whatever the hexadecimal number is there, convert into binary. Okay, so you know that each bit you are converting into 4 bits of the binary, and you can do the AND operation. You are getting 3333H. Okay, this is the result. You are getting 1111H, that is 111, that you are getting into AX. BX will remain safe. Okay, so this is AND operation. Okay, and next, this is OR operation. So what is OR operation? So you are moving AX with 1111H, BX with 3333H. So OR AX comma BX, it will do the OR operation, logical OR. And the content of AX and content of BX, and the result will be stored back to the AX. Okay, so you know the truth table of OR gate. OR gate means if any of the input is one, okay, the output will be one. Okay, so that means AX equal to what you are getting, 3333H. Okay, similarly, so this is the output. Next, this XOR gate. Okay, XOR gate means you are moving the 16-bit value 111H into AX, BX has 3333H. Okay, so XOR AX comma BX means if a different number of inputs are there, you are getting the output as 1, and the same number of inputs are there, you are getting the output as 0. Okay, so that means when you are doing XOR operation, this is the result, 2222H you are getting in AX. Okay, so this is NOT operation. NOT operation means what? Simply ones complement. So zeros will change into ones, ones will be changed into zeros. Okay, so you have moved AX with 1111H. Okay, so what happens when you are doing NOT operation? It will convert it into EEEH. Okay, so convert this 1111H into binary and do the ones complement, converting ones to zeros and zeros to ones, and you will get EEH. Okay, so negate, so negate is same as the ones complement, negate EEH. So negate EEH. So string instructions I will tell you. So you see, I'll show you in the program these logical instructions. So logical instructions, if you see, these are easy. Logical instructions are easy. Okay, so save, exit. So edit, logical, so I'm using logical.asf. Okay, so assume CS code segment start move AX comma 3333H. Okay, so move X comma 1111H. Okay, so and AX comma BX. Okay, here itself I am doing, or AX comma gates, and XOR AX comma BX, and not AX, not AX, negate AX. Okay, so next int 03H codeends end start. Okay, so I think the logical operations you know. Okay, so this program I'm going to execute. Okay, so alt f s alt f x masm logical dot asm semicolon. Okay, you are getting 0 and 101. Link logical dot obj semicolon debug logical dot exe. Okay, enter. Now you can trace. Okay, ax you got 3333h, again bx you got 1111h. Next AND operation, no? So AND operation is AX you got 1111H. Okay. And OR operation. Okay. So every time you need to initialize in the program. Why? Because AX will change. No? Okay. In my program, what I am doing, every time the AX will change to what I am doing, I am initializing AX with the AX with that value. Okay. 3333H. Okay. So here also, move AX comma 3333H. Again here move AX comma 3333H. Move AX comma 3333H. Okay, and same this part masm logical dot asm link, okay, debug, okay, trace, AX you got 3333H, trace, BX you got 1111H, trace, and so AX AND operation, AX, so whatever the AND operation is there, AX result is getting into AX is 1111H. Again you are initializing AX with 3333H. And next OR operation, so that is AX equal to 3333H. Again XOR operation, okay, so that XOR operation you are getting into 3333H. Okay, this is XOR operation 4222H, this is the result. Okay, again you are initializing AX with 3333H. You are doing the ones complement, so ones complement of this 3333H is nothing but CCCCC. Okay, again trace, you are initializing AX with 3333H, negate, same you are getting CC. So negate is nothing but two's complement. Okay, you need to remember, not is nothing but one's complement. So for the one's complement, if you add one to this one's complement, you are getting the two's complement. Okay, so initially whenever you are doing the NOT operation, you got the result in AX, that is CCCC. Okay, so whenever you do your negate operation, okay, so negate operation, that is CCCC. So adding 1 to C, it becomes a D. Okay, CCCCDH. Okay, so this is how we need to do this program. Okay, logical instruction.
Ma'am, A section ki 13 keys na, no? B section ki 13
keys. So A section B 13, B section B 12. Plan classes 12 and 13. Okay, so now repeat without dot is. So here, you know what you need to do. You need to move some values from one location to another location by using this string and without. Okay, so I will tell you that program. So this comes out of the first program. Okay, so. Okay. So if you see, this is string operations. String related operations. This will comes under the first program only. String. String operation. Okay. So here what you should do. So first is I'm writing the program without string. Okay. So you can use clear direction flag also. Clear direction flag or okay. So so if you see, there are two memory locations. This is 1000 location and this is 2000 location. Okay.
So third is 3 option, become 4 option, ETA is 5 option.
So here, five memory locations are there. 1000, 1001, 1002, 1003, and 1004. Okay, and 2001, 2002, 2003, 2004. Okay, some values are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 9, 8. Okay, so these values you are moving, madam. You are move should move to 1, 2, H. Okay, madam. So you should move to this 1, 2, H, and next. 3, 4, H. Okay, so whatever these five values are there, you should move to 1000 to 2000 H. Okay, so you can write this program by using the with string and without string. Okay, first I'm writing this program with string. Okay, so here dot model small without string. Okay, so this is without string. So without string, so dot model small, you can use this dot model small. Okay, so dot model small dot code, you can use that one or this one, both are same. Okay, so dot code, so first what you should do, you have to initialize this one is saved in the SI. Okay, so this is the data segment. Data segment is saved in SI. Okay, and this is the extra segment saved in DA. Okay, so whatever the data present in DS and SI, you are moving into the destination, that is ES and DA. Okay, so you have to initialize this one. So move SI comma 1000 H, move DA comma 2000 H. Okay, so next what you should do directly, so during the instruction set I told you directly you can't move the values location to another location. Okay, so between the two memory location you can't send the data. So what you should do, you have to use one intermediate register. First what I am doing, I'm using an Yale register. So whatever the content of 1000H location, you are moving into Yale. Okay. Again, you are moving the content of Yale into 2000. Okay. So you are moving. So that means you can use the direct address, or this address is pointed by SI and DA. No, you can use the indirect addressing mode. So that means this is SI, move AL comma SI, move DA comma A. Okay. So after moving one data, what you should do? You should increment the memory location. So initially from the 1000, you move to 2000. Okay. So after that, you have to increment the memory location. Okay. So what you should do? Increment SI, increment DA. Okay. Increment DA. So how many values you need to send? 5 values. So that means you have to initialize the count move CX comma 0005H. So how many values you need to move from the location? You have to initialize the count, okay? And next, loop back. You should use loop back. So what the loop instruction will do? It will be 2-in-1 instruction. That means it will decrement the count. Okay? Check for the condition. It is 0 or not. That means jump is not equal to 0. So that means it will decrement the count, and the jump is not equal to 0. So where I can keep back? So where I can keep that, move AL comma SL. Okay. So move AL comma SL. Okay. So that means that this will be repeated till what happens, count becomes zero. So till the count becomes zero, this will be repeated. Okay. So the same program you can use with string. Okay. That means we can replace this whole these 5 lines you can use by using this instruction. Repeat move SB. Okay, this is with string. With string, and another one is without string. Okay, so repeat move SB. So what this will do? This will move whatever the content from SI to DA. So parallelly, it will increment and decrement DA. So what happens? The loop back. The loop back means it will be repeated. Okay. So till the count becomes zero. Okay. So I will show you this program. Here dot model small dot code move SI comma 1000 move DA comma 2000 count I initialized. Okay, so this is without string. Move AL comma SI move DA comma AL increment SI increment DA loop back into 03H and enter. Okay, so alt F X masm. Okay, so masm without file name. My file name is without string. Okay, you have to give the file name such a way that you have to remember the program. Okay, ASM semicolon. I got 0x and 0 warnings. Link file name without string dot obg semicolon. Debug without string dot ex. Okay. So in order to enter the values into the memory location, you have to use E. E is for entering the values into the memory location. E space ds colon 2000 enter. Okay, so I'm giving the values 12 space 34 space 45 space 56 space 78 space. Okay, how many values are over? 5 values are over. 1 2 3 4 5. Okay, so enter, press G. Okay, now I want to see E space ds colon 1000 in the 1000 I need to give the values in the location 1 2 space 3 4 space 5 6 space 7 8 space 8 9 space 9 yes enter g enter d space ds colon 4000 la l suppose if I want to see 5 values I can use l5 okay suppose if you are not using this means you will get all these values okay so g I'm pressing okay so is d space ds colon 2000 and l5 okay so one second Massam debug e space ds colon 1000 1 2 enter space 3 4 space 5 6 space 7 8 space 8 9 space 9 8 enter so suppose if I want to see these values d space ds colon 1000 L5 whether these values are came or not I want to verify g enter d space ds colon g is for running the program 2000 L5 enter okay these values came whatever the values present in the 1000 location I got into the 2000 location okay so that means by using this without string instructions I can transfer the values from the 1000 location to the 2000 location okay 075A is nothing but the address of the data segment okay so again next I'm going to this program edit with string I will see with string okay sorry one second with string so I want to enter the with the string here with string dot is dot string string dot is here I said this string dot is okay so dot model small dot code move si comma 1000 move di comma 2000 move cx comma so whatever the count how many values you want to send from 1000 to 2000 location you are using this 5 okay and repeat move sp this is a prefix instruction so whatever the content from 1000 location you are moving to 2000 location for every moment of this value you have to increment the SI and DI okay so that 5 instructions without string the 5 instructions are there yeah? That 5 instructions operations will be done by only one instruction okay so so see so exit so what is my file name with string no? So open. String dot as okay. So file exit massam string dot asm semicolon okay. Link string dot obj semicolon debug string dot exe. Okay enter e space ds colon 1000 okay enter 1 2 space 3 4 space 5 6 space 6 7 space 7 8 space 9 some a okay enter g enter d space ds colon 2000 l5 okay So these values you got into this five values only, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6, 7, 7, 8. You got into these values. Okay. So like this, you have to write the program without string and with string. Okay. So in the manual, I will change the program with string and without string, and I will share you. Okay.